Hi all, in this video, let's learn about top 5 JavaScript questions on Stack Overflow. So let me show you the top 5 questions of JavaScript in the Stack Overflow. So these are the 5 top voted JavaScript questions on the Stack Overflow. Today, let's discuss about one by one and with all the other cases as well. So this is the first question. How can I remove a specific item from an array? So in this question, there will be 3 scenarios. So let's discuss one by one. So the first thing is, so we want to delete a specific item in an array. There would be 3 cases for this. The first case is if you mention a particular position or particular value or a particular value of all the elements. So let's discuss one by one. So we are going to delete an item at a particular position. We can use splice operator for this. So the splice operator takes 2 parameters. First one is the starting position. It means an index. Second one is the count, how many elements to be removed. So for example, if we have an array like this, so if we want to add the splice element, I'm adding the splice operation and I'm giving 3.2. What does it exactly mean? 3 is the index. So from 3 index, we are going to remove 2 items. So it means 1, 0 index, 1 index, 2 index. So from 3, so 5A. So these 2 would be removed. 2 elements would be removed because we have mentioned item 2. So that's the reason these 2 elements would be removed. So if you want to delete any specific item from an array, if you know the position, then you can use this splice. You can use this splice and you can mention that position, exact position, which position item you wanted to remove. You can exactly mention that. And if you want to only remove 1 element, you can give the 1 as a delete count. So then only that element would be deleted. So this is how you can delete an element at the particular position. So fine. So now let me do a small quiz type thing. So what would be the output for this when you are using the splice? We need to understand this better because all the time, if you an array was given and we are splicing that with the 2 elements, index 2. So 0, 1, 2. From this point, we are going to delete 1 item. So now what is the return output? So we'll be getting not the new array like 1, 2. We'll not be getting an array like 1, 2, or we'll not be getting the length of the array. We'll be getting the deleted array. So it is like this. We'll be 3 would be returned. So if you hover on the splice, so you can see the return statement. An array containing the elements that were deleted. It will return the elements that are deleted. So 3 was deleted in this operation. So it will return, the return value would be array with 3. So we need to understand what is the return type exactly while we are using splice as well. So just to work out with the other issues, I have explained this. So coming to the second scenario of deleting an item. So if you want to delete an item in an array with a particular value. So here we have seen with a particular position, but here we need to see with a particular value. Then first we need to do, we need to find the index of that value and then we need to delete that element. So for that, so we need to do like this. So let me take one variable index. So we know the value. If you want to delete a value of 5, so first you need to know its index value. So array dot index of, we'll be having an index of operator. So I will find the index of 5. So now I will get the index of this 5. Later on, same. We are going to splice this operator with that index. So you can see that index, comma 1. So if you do this, what happens? First, now in this array, we are trying to find the particular value. So we want to delete a value 5. So particular value 5. For that, we need to find its exact position. For that, we are using index of. So if you use index of 5, it will return the first element of. If the 5 is available at the last also, it will return the first index of the 5. So this 5 index would be returned here and we are splicing that element with 1. So in this way, we can delete an element, particular value. For that, we need to find the index and we need to delete with the splice operator. What if we want to delete all the elements of the particular value? For example, if you want to delete this 5, which is existing here as well. So it means there are 2 5s here. So how to remove these 2 5 elements, particular value of 2 5 elements in an array. So for that, we need to write a small piece of code, which will be repeating the same this in a for loop. That's it. Yep, we'll write this. So let me take a function. So remove all. So which takes the array. I will send the array and the particular value to be deleted, which value I wanted to delete. So that I will write, I will send. So this is the array I'm sending, and 5 is the item I wanted to delete. So I'm calling this function. So now you can see I called an array and 5. So now what we need to do exactly is we are looping a function. So I'm taking one for loop. So instead starting from the beginning, it's good to start with the end. So the reason why we are checking for the particular item from the end is, in an array, if you are deleting any of the operation, then the rearranging of the indexes would be occurred. Rearranging means it takes some operation. So instead from back to front, if you do the rearranging of indexes from the front to back, back to front, it gives more performance. Instead rearranging from front to back, if you do from back to front, it gives more performance related. So that's the reason I'm starting the array index from the back to front. So that's the reason I have not taken it from zero. I have taken it from last element. So I'm minusing this element. So I need to find whether the array of this element is equal to, triple equal to the value which I'm sending to delete. If we found that, we can splice it. I would be the index now, so we can directly splice it. So this is what we need to do if we wanted to delete all the elements of the particular. So I think I have confused here, but I will, let me explain you why we have taken from the index from the last, because it reduces the rearranging of the indexes. So that's the reason we have taken the array from the last, pointed the array from the last. So this is about how to delete all the elements of a particular value in an array. So hope you understand. So coming to the second question, how to check if an item or element is hidden in JavaScript? So let's take here. So I have taken one HTML. So I have given one ID, and by default, hiding means I'm hiding that element with the visibility. Every element will have this visibility. By default, it would be visible. I'm making this visibility to hidden. So in sense, there are three items. I'm making one item hidden by default. So the task now is we need to find how to find out that item is visible or not. For that, we need to first pick that item. So we have picked that item. So now we have that item in our hand. So now what we need to do is we are going to do a style. And we have an operator called windows.get computed style. So this computed style will give all the styles which are applied to this particular item. So keep this reference here. So now what happens, this in this computed style, all the styles would be available here. So once this style variable consists of all the styles, now we need to check whether it is hidden or not. So let me check whether it is hidden or not. So like this, so style dot, now we can get the property. So we can get property value. So this window.get computed style will give all the styles which are applied on this element. And with this style, we are picking the property value of visibility, whether this is available or not. Whether this variable is available or not. I think I have right spelling check here. So now, if this returns true, it means we could, if this element is disabled, hidden. If not, it is enabled. So in that way, we can conclude this. So let me console this. In this way, we can find whether the element is available or not. So let's check that in the browser. So hidden. So I have printed this. So it is telling this element is hidden. It is not visible. We can check this in the network tab as well. So let me check this. Yeah. Okay, I will reduce the computed value. So in the computed value, it will give the windows dot. If you say the windows dot computed value here, it will give like, as I said, window dot get computed style. And if we mention the hide item, so it will give, let me check, computed hidden item. Oh yeah, hidden item. So if you give hidden item with the windows.getComputed style, you'll be getting all the styles. So let me show you that. So here you will be having this. So here in the Windows style, see, you have visibility hidden. So you can check, uncheck this. So based upon this, we can find whether an element is hidden or not with the JavaScript. So for that, we have used window.getComputed style. So what does this getComputed style gives? It gives all the computed values here, which are available here. So it will give all these values, getComputed value means. So there, from there, you are getting the particular visibility property, and we are checking whether that item is hidden or not. So this is all about the second point. So coming to the third point, what does use strict do in JavaScript? So usually JavaScript is a very flexible language where it provides a lot of freedom for the developers. Because of providing this freedom, there would be some unwanted errors would be also occurring. So that's the reason in ES5, the use strict was being introduced. With this use strict, you can use at any of the line, at the starting of the application or the starting of the function or any point, you can use this use strict. From that point, the used all the rules would be applied to the code. So for example, in the use strict, there would be two main there would be n number of points, but I will be touching just 2 points. Like you can't use undeclared variables. Like for example, I can't do like this. If you mention the use strict like this in a function, useState. So we need to mention like this useState. And if you use like this, it will throw an error. It will not allow us to do this. This is because we are making the developers to code in a right way. So before declaring any of the variable, we should not use that variable. This is not a good idea. So that's the reason we are using useState, so that we are making developers to go in a right direction and to follow the right standards. So that's the reason it's a good idea to use useState in the JavaScript. It will handle many more rules. The best one would be like this. If you use a variable like this, usually the JavaScript allows this. But if you use this in a strict mode, it will tell us the undeclared variables are not allowed. So this is what it would be declaring us. It will throw an error like this, undeclared variables are not allowed. So it will show an error like this. So it will stop if you use a strict mode and if you misuse the code like this. So one more important and very useful one which I have learned is like it will prohibit this function. So usually when we use like this, so if you want to use anything like this, so what does this exactly return? This will return the window object. So this will return entire window object. So if you use strict mode here, so you can use strict mode anywhere like this. From here, the strict mode rules would be applied. So if you use strict mode in this point, now this would be returned as undefined. It will prohibit this value to the outside world. So this is also the best thing which I have learned. So by using this use strict, we can prohibit this window object to outside world. So you can have a set of rules. You can understand why to use this use strict, but it will make us to go in a right direction by pointing us more errors. So that's the reason we'll be using this use strict. So coming to the fourth point, how to redirect to the another page. There are two ways to redirect to the another page. One is location.href is equal to, you can give the, a URL. So we'll see that in the Windows there, here directly in the browser. You can go to the console. So there would be two ways. So let me read the question once again, how to redirect to another web page. So you can use two ways, like location.href, and here you can mention any of the web page, like you can give www.google.com. So now we can redirect to google.com. If I click enter, it would be redirect to google.com. So this is one way, and the other way is you can use location.replace. So this is also same as a href. And here you need to mention the URL to which web page you wanted to redirect. So these are the two ways. So number one is href and number two is replace. So in these two ways, you can redirect to another page. So coming to the fifth point, how to check whether a string contains another substring. So for that, you can have like, let me take one string where string is equal to simple and substring. So So let's just wanted to mention the substring as well. So in ES6, we can do this with in index of. So unlike we have in arrays, we'll be having index of. Similarly, in the strings also, we'll be having index of. So in ES5, we'll be doing it with the index of. Like we'll be checking string dot index of. So index string index of will be also available for strings, not only just for arrays. So you can check this. So if you check like this, index of this substring, and this should not be equal to -1. So let me write this. So this should not be equal to -1. Then it will return whether this item is available or not. So this is one way. We do this in the ES6. This is the point of doing in ES6. Coming to ES5, sorry, we do index of in ES5. Coming to ES6, we have a new operator called includes. So which directly we can use string dot includes. So you can use the includes function, and you can mention the substring. So this is how you can check whether a string consists of substring or not. These are the two ways. This is for the index of we use for the ES6, and from ES5. Sorry, index of will be using for ES5, and includes is a new function of strings which was introduced in ES6. Will be latest in the latest ES6, we'll be using includes. So in this way, we can check whether a string contains the substring or not. So in the both the cases, who will be OO will be available in FOO. So in that way, both would be returned true. So these are the five top questions of the JavaScript on Stack Overflow. Hope you understand the video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for the more videos.